Hi, my name is Subodh, and I present to you our IROS paper titled Experimental Evaluation of 3D LiDAR Camera Extrinsic Calibration. Here is a short overview of the presentation. First, we introduce our work. Next, we pose the calibration problem, and then we provide a brief theoretical background of all the calibration methods we have compared. We also list the motivation behind choosing these algorithms. Moving on, we provide a description of the sensor suite used to evaluate these algorithms. After that, we elaborate on the experiments conducted, and finally, we end with some discussions. Most modern autonomy stacks use cameras and LiDARs together to better understand the environment, and also for multi-sensor positioning and mapping. This requires a knowledge of extrinsic calibration between cameras and LiDARs, which is often assumed to be known a priori. Although many labs and organizations have developed their own algorithms to estimate the extrinsic calibration, a comprehensive work which analyzes different methods and provides experimental evaluation is lacking. In this work, we perform experimental evaluation of three target-based approaches for spatial calibration of cameras and 3D LiDARs. We want to emphasize that all these algorithms we have compared use easy-to-fabricate calibration targets. We offer insights into strengths and weaknesses of the algorithms and provide interesting avenues for further work. For a pinhole camera model, pi, the relationship between any points PLI detected in a 3D LiDAR and its image projection PCI is given in equation 1, which involves the extrinsic calibration parameters CRL and CTL. The goal of any camera LiDAR extrinsic calibration algorithm is to estimate these parameters. In this work, we assume that the intrinsic calibration parameters K and also the lens distortion parameters are known. In this work, we compare three different 3D LiDAR camera calibration algorithms, namely the point-to-plane constraint-based calibration, PPC-Cal, which does pairwise calibration of LiDAR camera pairs using a point-to-plane distance minimization constraint, the point-to-back projected plane-based calibration, PBPC-Cal, which does pairwise calibration of LiDAR camera pairs using a point-to-back projected plane distance minimization constraint, and finally, the multi-sensor graph-based calibration, MSG-Cal, which uses point-to-plane constraints for pairwise calibration, and on top of that, it adds an additional layer of joint graph-based optimization for multi-sensor systems. The details of all these algorithms can be found in the cited papers. Why, after all, we pick these three algorithms for comparison? First, like stated earlier, these methods use easy-to-build planar calibration targets, unlike some other methods which depend on multiple targets or complicated targets, and maybe sometimes both. Our goal is to compare methods which can be used without depending on complicated paraphernalia. Secondly, their respective optimization backends utilize easy to detect geometrical features like planes and lines along all the sensing modalities. Lastly, we choose MSG-Cal because it's a graph-based calibration method, and we wanted to see how a graph-based approach performs differently from pairwise calibration methods. The table here presents a theoretical comparison of the three methods. PPC-Cal uses a planar checkerboard, PBPC-Cal uses a planar whiteboard of known dimensions, and MSG-Cal uses a planar April tag board. For feature detection in camera, PPC-Cal detects a checkerboard pattern on a planar target. PBPC-Cal detects the edges of the planar whiteboard. And MSG-Cal detects the April tag pattern on a planar target. For feature detection in LiDAR, PPC-Cal detects the points on the target surface. PBPC-Cal detects the points on both the surface and its edges. MSG-Cal also detects the points on the respective target surface, but it does not use those points explicitly, and rather derives planar parameters N and D from these points and uses those parameters to represent the observed planar points. Theoretically, PPC-Cal claims that the results of calibration will be observable with only three non-coplanar views, and PBPC-Cal claims that only two non-coplanar views are enough. MSG-Cal, however, makes no such claims. But it must be kept in mind that all the three methods discussed here encourage that enough views are provided to ensure robustness. Data collection in PPCCAL and MSGCAL is easier because only the planner points need to be detected in LiDAR. But in PVPCCAL, we also need to detect the edges of the planner target in the LiDAR sensor. And hence, we have to hold the target in a way which makes the detection of the edges easier. Hence, it can be tedious at times. This picture shows the sensor suite we have used to compare the performance of all the algorithms. We have two different LiDARs, namely the Ouster 64-channel LiDAR and Velodyne VLP 32-channel LiDAR, and three different cameras, out of which two form a stereo pair, such that the factory stereo calibration is known and it can be used as ground truth. We evaluate these algorithms by A, comparing their robustness to random initialization of extrinsic calibration parameters, B, by comparing the estimated calibration parameters with the factory stereo calibration, C, by using the estimated calibration parameters to project edge points of the planner target detected in LiDAR onto the camera image and calculating the mean line reprojection error. And finally, by D, comparing the time taken by respective solvers to converge to a solution. The factory stereo calibration error is the error between the known stereo calibration C1, TC2, and the composition of the estimated transforms C1, TL, and C2, TL. Mean line reprojection error, MLRE, is the average perpendicular distance between the planner target's edge detected in camera and the projections of the corresponding edge points detected in LiDAR. These projections are calculated using the estimated extrinsic calibration parameters. And hence, the MLRE tells us how good or bad the estimation is. Figure 2 shows the response of PPCCAL, PBPCCAL, and MSGCAL to random initialization in red, green, and blue, respectively. As shown in the figure, PPCCAL and PBPCCAL are robust to random initialization, while MSGCAL exhibits divergence in a few cases. All the methods converge to nearly the same rotational values, but show variation in translational values. This is because the point-to-plane constraint used in all the methods is better at constraining rotation than at constraining translation. PBPCCAL uses an additional point-to-back projected plane constraint, which helps improve translation estimation accuracy. Table 1 presents the errors with respect to the known stereo calibration for both Velodyne and Ouster LiDARs and the stereo pair. As observed in the table, PPCCAL and MSGCAL show error in the order of 1 cm along the stereo baseline, that is the z-axis, as compared to 4.5 mm in PBPCCAL. For Ouster LiDAR, PPCCAL shows better performance than others. MSGCAL gives the same error for both the LiDARs because it's a graph-based calibration algorithm and does joint optimization of all the sensors together. It is difficult to draw definitive conclusions from these experiments. So we move to compare the mean line reprojection error. Figure 3 and Table 2 present the mean line reprojection errors for all the LiDAR camera pairs, and they present the results from the same scenario. So here we focus on the table because comparing the numbers here is easier. Clearly, PBPCCAL performs best. PBPCCAL is also more consistent for all the camera LiDAR pairs, as evident from a low standard deviation. PPCCAL shows deterioration in performance when used on an Ouster LiDAR camera setup. MSGCAL performs worse here. As noted in the paper concerning PBPCCAL, Ouster LiDAR is a noisy sensor, and we hypothesize that PPCCAL gives poorer result because it is affected by this noise. And PBPCCAL is not affected by it as much because it uses additional geometric constraints. MSGCAL, being a graph-based approach, perhaps has all its nodes affected by a single noisy sensor. To verify our hypothesis, we calibrate the sensor suite with Ouster LiDAR removed from it and present the results in Figure 4 and Table 3. On comparing Figures 4, A, B, and C against Figures 4, D, E, and F, which present results with and without Ouster LiDAR respectively, we can conclude that MSGCAL performs better when the outer LiDAR is removed. As seen in figures 4, D, E, and F, the projected LiDAR edge points are well aligned with the edges of the planar whiteboard, which is not the case in figures 4, A, B, and C. From table 3, we can conclude that PPCCAL and MSGCAL give comparable performance when the outer LiDAR is removed. And this is expected because MSGCAL uses the same point-to-plane geometric constraint for pairwise calibration that PPCCAL uses. The comparison table 4 shows the time taken for convergence in all the sensor pairs with all the three methods. Clearly, MSGCAL takes significantly less time, and this is because PPCCAL and PBPCCAL explicitly use the LiDAR points in the optimization procedure, while MSGCAL uses plane parameters derived from these points. Therefore, the number of residuals in MSGCAL is significantly less, which explains why it takes the least time to converge to a solution. After analyzing all experimental results, we can draw the following conclusions. PPCCAL and PBPCCAL are robust to initialization for all trials, while MSGCAL diverges in a few. PBPCCAL, which uses only point-to-plane constraint, shows deterioration in performance when noisy sensor is used. PBPCCAL shows better performance in the presence of a noisy sensor because it uses additional geometric constraints. MSGCAL, which uses a variant of point-to-plane geometric constraint, has all pairwise calibrations affected in the presence of a noisy sensor, but performs at par with PPCCAL when the noisy sensor is removed. MSGCAL takes the least time to converge when compared to other two methods. I want to conclude my presentation with some remarks on what calibration algorithms to use and when. If you do not have a noisy sensor and need a quick calibration, then using PPCCAL should suffice. If you have multiple sensors which are not noisy, then MSGCAL is preferable. But if we have noisy sensors, then PBPCCAL is recommended because it adds more geometrical constraints across modalities to reduce the effect of sensor noise. Finally, in our future work, we want to use the constraints used in PBPCCAL in the pairwise calibration step of MSGCAL, thus bringing the advantages of robust pairwise calibration and joint graph-based optimization together. Thank you.